Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi
warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh, sir.
wabarakatuh, Zermizi. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening,
Good
sir.
evening, good evening, sir.
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. How about you?
How about you?
I'm fine too, alhamdulillah. Okay, guys, will you read to me what you can see on the screen?
Isaiah 24, we go to the
Very good. April 2024, week 4, Tuesday. Let's finish with me. Very good. Thank you so much. Okay, as usual, before that, I want you to write down the date for today in your own notebook. Okay, as usual, I'm going to tell you about the rules during online learning. The first one is you have to be very quiet during the explanation. Number two, please be very focused in the class and make sure there are no noises around you. Number three, raise your hand if you want to show that you have done your job. And also raise your hand if you want to ask me something. Just use the button in your Zoom devices. Number four, write down the notes that you can see on the screen. And the last one is communicate, meaning that you have to take part in the learning activity throughout the session. So these are the five rules that you need to know during online learning. Okay, before we start our class, I'm going to say, hi, Akil. Hello, Sophia. Hello, Iman Daniel. Hi, Nara. Hi, Arjuna. Hi, Kisha. Hi, Raif Arshad. Hi, Chris. Hi, Adam. Hi, Muhammad Daniel. And hello, Fia. Welcome to our last session for April. Okay, guys.
Hi, sir.
Hi, Adam. Adam, gitu?
Tak, kakak.
Oh, Huda. Okay, hi. How are you, Huda?
I'm fine.
How was your MRSM?
Good.
They told me that MRSM have a lot of nice food, isn't it?
I don't know because sometimes I skip the lunch, the dinner.
You skip the lunch and the dinner because of?
Because the quantities of food is too much.
Oh, kenyang already lah. Full.
Yes.
Full. Okay, good, good, good. So how was your study there?
For now, good. But after next week, I have an exam.
What I understand is MRSM teacher does not teach you a lot. You need to find your own knowledge, isn't it true?
Yes.
Oh my
it
God.
Just adjust the point. You need to know the details by yourself.
Oh my God. Meaning that you're going to get astray from the right path.
Yes.
Okay. So that is kind of a teaching for the SBP, I believe so. Sekolah Brahma Penuh. They don't spoon feed you. They just give you maybe a little bit of topics and you need to find and you have to do a lot of tasks, assignments. Isn't it like that?
Yes.
Can you still lah? Tapi actually it's going to be struggle, Huda. So don't give up. You have to move on, keep moving on. And I know the libraries there is very huge. You can look for a lot of knowledge there. You can find out a lot of reference there. So don't give up. Sebab I know cara M, you're going to be shocked by the cara MBS, apa? Cara MRSSM sebab kat sekolah kita lain, masa sekolah rendah. Bila pergi MRSSM pun lain pula caranya. So don't give up, Huda. Just go ahead. I know you're going to be struggling. Especially when exam, when you are entering form 3, something like that. Just keep moving on, Huda. And when you are thinking about giving up, just think back that why I start.
Okay,
I wish you, I pray you for the best for you in MRSM. Masuk universiti baru bagus, kau boleh masuk universiti luar negara. Make your parent proud. Okay, dan doakan adik-adik kamu dalam kelas ni. Okay, berjaya macam kamu juga dapat sekolah yang tak kisahlah MRSM ke sekolah mana-mana lah. Yang penting berjaya. Okay, amin.
InsyaAllah, sir. Okay.
Okay, thank you, Huda. Okay, nice. Very good. Okay, now we continue back. So, what we're going to learn today is... Hi, Tarani. Welcome to the class. We're just starting our class. So, actually, I'm going to... what we call... I'm going to... proceed or continue the topic of conjunction. We have learned about subordinating conjunction. We have learned about coordinating conjunction. We also learned about correlative conjunctions. So today we're going to learn some more conjunction, the final conjunction, which is conjunctive adverbs. This is very good when you are writing. When you are writing, what we call it in English, a storytelling. Okay, and then it's very good for writing the facts, factual fakta, karangan berfakta, factual composition. So this is very good for you to use and very simple. Conjunctive adverb is very simple compared to subordinating conjunction and correlative conjunctions. This is very simple one. So, get ready. Iman Dini, jangan terkejut sangat. Nampak muka terkejut je tu. Okay juga Iman Dini.
Okay.
Berapa markah dia jawab?
Apa?
Exam dapat berapa? Exam kelas dapat berapa? Lupa dah. 70 something isn't it? Kan Iman ini 70 something rasanya. Okay.
75 ke atas.
Yeah, congratulations. Soalan tu susah sebenarnya. Siapa yang dapat 70 ke atas tu is considered very bright lah. Okay, congratulations Iman Daniel. So, we're going to learn about conjunctive adverbs today, Iman Daniel. So, I want everyone in this class give me attention. Okay? So, this is kind of... it's not quite difficult. It's actually... you already know the words. But this is literally know the words. Macam coordinating conjunction. Walaupun kamu tahu perkataan tu. Tapi maksudnya berbeza. Contohnya for... bukannya untuk kan, jadi sebab kan. So untuk ini simple, this is very simple one. So sila salin tajuk ini dalam buku masing-masing, conjunctive adverbs.
Dah siap, sir.
Very good, Arjuna. Arjuna masih lagi merentas desa di sekolah?
Dah habis dah, dah lepas.
So hari ini merentas apa?
Hah, tak ada.
Tak ada dah, okay. Tak ada sukan-sukan dah?
Tak ada.
Okay, good. So, we're going to go to the next page. So, why... I want you to write it down. What is the meaning of conjunctive adverb while I am explaining it to you. Meanwhile, I am going to explain it to you. I'm going to explain it to you. Yep. Okay, what are conjunctive adverbs? Conjunctive adverbs are words, perkataan, that connect and relate to independent clauses or sentences. Oh, dia mudah je. Dia adalah independent clauses. Maksudnya, ataupun sentences, maksudnya clauses dan sentences tu boleh berdiri sendiri. Kemudian, they show relationship such as dia menunjukkan perhubungan. Sentence number one dan sentence number two ada perkaitan. Clauses number one, clauses number two ada perkaitan. This is a conjunctive adverbs. So they show relationships such as cause and effect, sebab dan punca, sebab dan akibat, contrast, perbeza. Contrast is a contradiction. Contrast is contradiction. Maksudnya, Abu pemarah. Saya belajar bersungguh-sungguh tetapi saya gagal. Itu contradiction. Comparison adalah perbandingan. Abu pemarah tetapi baik hati. Itu perbandingan. Time or sequence. Time itu maksudnya masa dan sequence maksudnya kemudian, selepas itu, macam tu. Yang kita seajar kamu dulu, ingat tak? Dalam karangan moreover, furthermore, ingat? Iman Daniel?
Ingat.
Sepanggil apa tu? Time apa tu? Time connector ke sepanggil? Time connector, seistilahkan kan? So, this is very good untuk kamu gunakan dalam karangan kamu. So, sila angkat tangan siapa yang dah siap salin.
Dah siap.
Okay, very good.
So,
yes.
Boleh terangkan baik tak? Cause tu apa, effect tu apa, contrast tu apa, comparison tu apa, time tu apa.
Okay.
Or...
Tak ada masalah. Okay, so terangkan kembali. Okay. Now, what are conjunctive adverbs? Conjunctive adverb tu apa dia? So, conjunctive adverbs are words. Perkataan. Dia perkataan. Perkataan. Okay. That connect. Connect tu maksudnya menghubungi. Okay. And relate, berkaitan. Two independent. Dua independent clauses and sentences. Okay. Clauses dan sentences ni. Okay. Sentence tu ayat. Okay. Sentence tu ayat. Saya makan nasi. Itu adalah ayat. Clauses. Clauses ni dia boleh jadi ayat. Tak. Orang kata dalam bahasa kata semua sentence adalah clauses. Tapi bukan semua clauses adalah sentence. Itu bahasa Inggeris yang serujuk. So, clauses ni contohnya saya makan. Boleh berdiri di kaki sendiri sebab dia clauses. Berdiri di kaki sendiri. Dia boleh ada makna. Saya makan. Macam tu. So, tetapi kalau sentences, dia lebih lengkap. Saya makan nasi. Nak lengkap lagi. Saya makan nasi di restoran. Itu adalah sentences. Clauses ni lebih, ni, dia punya unit dia lebih kecil sikit daripada sentences. So, apa maksud independent? Macam saya bagi tahu tadilah. Dia boleh berdiri di atas kaki sendiri. Maksudnya, saya makan boleh berdiri kaki sendiri. Saya makan nasi di restoran boleh berdiri di kaki boleh berdiri di atas kaki sendiri. Kalau yang tidak boleh berdiri di kaki sendiri, contohnya sebab saya makan. Boleh tak berdiri di atas kaki sendiri? Kamu tertanya-tanya, sebab saya makan, ayat itu tergantung. Seperti mana saya terangkan masa subordinating conjunction, saya ada bagi tahu konsep dia independent ayat lengkap, independent ayat lengkap betul, dependent ayat tergantung. So dekat hari ini adalah ayat ataupun clauses yang lengkap. Okay, guys, sekejap lagi kita tunjuk contoh-contoh dia supaya kamu boleh faham. Okay, they show relationship, perhubungan, such as cause and effect, sebab dan kesan. I eat mangoes. Saya makan mangga. Sebab itu adalah cause dan kesan dia, I have stomach ache. Itu maksudnya cause and effect. Contrast macam mana pula? Apa beza contrast and comparison? Contrast ni macam ni. I work hard. I study a lot, but I failed the exam. Itu contrast. Terlalu kontra sangat. Ah, itu adalah contrast. Comparison adalah perbandingan. Saya suka, sorry, kereta abu berwarna putih manakala kereta Ali berwarna hijau. Perbandingan. Kontras ni adalah sesuatu perbuatan yang sangat kontras. Dia pandai berucap di, sorry, dia pandai berucap di hadapan di khalayak ramai. Tetapi kontras lah, kontras. Tetapi dia comparison pemalu kan. Tetapi dia tidak mampu untuk bercakap di telefon. Ha, contohlah. Maksudnya kontras berbeza gila. Penyataan pertama, sentence pertama berbeza dengan sentence kedua. Dia want contrast and comparison. Time or sequence tu mudah saja. Kemudian, selepas itu, dia macam tu. Okey, faham kan? Nak orang faham?
Faham.
Alhamdulillah. Okay, now kita akan, kamu dah siap salin, kamu dah angkat tangan. Very good yang angkat tangan. Thank you so much. Okay, maksudnya kita boleh pergi yang berikutnya. Okay, so sebenarnya conjunctive adverb ada banyak. Nak dekat 30 lebih. Tapi saya ambil 5 yang selalu kita jumpa dalam perbualan bahasa Inggeris. The most commonly used in English conversation. So these are the 5 conjunctive adverb that I'm going to explore it to you. The first one is how, where, however. Number 2, therefore. Number 3, moreover. Number 4, meanwhile. And number 5, nevertheless. Nevertheless. Dah salin ke belum? Kalau salin boleh angkat tangan. Very good. Thank you so much. Apa yang belum jawab exam, angkat emoji cherry.
Apa sih?
Saya.
Exam sekolah ke?
Dah exam kelas kita.
Oh.
Udah, Han jangan pergi tolong si ni pula, Adam. Han tengok je Huda tau. Bagi tahu Adam, bagi tahu Huda begitu. Okay, dah. Okay, good. Sorry yang sebatuk serta pasal makan gula-gula. Memang dah 4 sebulan dah mengatuk ni. Okay, now. Kita pergi satu-satu. However, indicates a contrast between two ideas. Menunjukkan perbezaan di antara dua idea lah. Tengok contoh dia. She loves to dance. However, she hates performing in front of large crowds. Inilah nama orang yang sebagai tato. Contrast. Beza gila-gila. Dia suka menari. Tapi dia tak minat nak perform depan orang ramai. Yang lain sila salin. Dah salin boleh angkat tangan.
Dah.
Angkat tangan.
Hah?
Angkat tangan. Baru 4 orang dah siap. Dah semua? Boleh saya pergi next page?
Belum, belum.
Belum.
Boleh.
Akil dah siap, Akil. Chris, Chris dah siap. Nawara, Pia.
Dah.
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 Iman Daniel, soalan tu susah Iman Daniel yang exam tu. Awal-awal tu senang lah kan.
Susah sikit, ada yang susah sikit kan.
Yang hujung-hujung kan yang nak sampai soal 50 tu kan.
Dah, so.
Okay, good. Now we're going to go to the next page, which is therefore. Therefore indicates a result or conclusion. Dia menunjukkan sebab, kesan. So, example, he studied hard for the exam, therefore he got an A. He got an A. It's very good. Sila salin, sorry. Dan if you look carefully, this is sentence number one. This is sentence number two. So if I am reading without the therefore, he study hard for the exam, he got an A. Ayat ini terpisah. So, tujuan adverb, conjunctive adverb adalah menghubungkan ayat yang sebelumnya. So, dengan menggunakan therefore, okay, dengan menggunakan therefore, dia terus menghubungkan ayat he got an A kepada he studied hard for the exam. Itu yang dimaksudkan dengan conjunctive adverb yang kata relationship, memberi perhubungan, to show the relationship. Inilah yang dimaksudkan. Tanpa ada conjunctive adverb, dia tidak dapat menghubungkan dengan ayat sebelumnya itu. So, macam mana dalam karangan kamu untuk menghubungkan ayat yang sebelum-sebelum-sebelumnya itu, kamu kena guna yang
Saya tak
sebelum
nampak.
hari ini. Minta maaf, sorry. So, kamu kena guna apa yang sebagi hari ini. Itu lima yang selalu digunakan. Ada berpuluh, tetapi saya ambil lima. Kalau saya ambil berpuluh-puluh tu, kelas kita habis 2 pagi, kita boleh terus buat kia mulai. So, sebagai 5 je.
Sir.
Yes.
Hari ini kuis ada tak? Bukan Kahoot.
Soalan ada, soalan ada. Ada 2 soalan hari ini. 2 praktis.
Okay.
Practice A,
Thanks.
Practice B. Okay, can I go to the next page?
Yes,
yes.
Thank you so much. Very good.
Yes.
So the next is about moreover. Indicates an addition to the previous idea. Maksudnya tambahan. Tambahan dan sebenarnya bahasa mudanya dan lagi, dan lagi, dan lagi, dan lagi. Moreover, moreover, moreover. So sebagai contoh. She is a talented musician. Moreover, she is an accomplished athlete. Accomplished tu maksudnya berjaya. So, she is a talented musician. Moreover, tambahan lagi, dan lagi, she is an accomplished athlete. Itu yang dimasukkan dengan moreover, penambahan. Okay, sila salin. Siapa dah siap salin boleh angkat tangan dan juga beruk kena belacan. Laju
sis, beruk kena belacan tu apa sis?
Carilah beruk mana-mana dalam dalam emoji tu. Tentu letak belacan tepi dia.
Okay.
Arjuna, confirm Arjuna screenshot kan?
Ni pakai laptop lah.
Yelah, ni print screen lah kan?
Ambil masa.
Salin ke print screen?
Salin.
Very good. Mesti salin lah. Bila salin, Arjuna akan ingat banyak. Ha, sampai dia punya simpanan dekat dekat minda tu kan. Arjuna, panjang berbanding kita screenshot. Bukan apa, Sir pun masuk IPG juga. Bila Sir ambil gambar dekat dekat apa tu, lecturer punya LCD projector tu semua tu, memang Sir tak ingat. Melainkan Sir salin nota yang dia bagi, baru Sir ingat. Itu petua belajar lah. Okay, thank you. Empat orang dah siap. Semua dah? Boleh sepergi next?
Ya.
Boleh.
Boleh.
Okay.
Ya, teruskan, teruskan.
Dah.
Sudah okey. Okey, boleh sepergi next?
Boleh, sir.
Okey.
Boleh.
So, yang berikutnya adalah meanwhile. Meanwhile indicates that two actions are happening simultaneously. Simultaneously. Simultaneously ni bahasa mudahnya serentak. Saja nak bunyi grand kan, simultaneously. Okay, berlaku serentak sebenarnya. So, cuba tengok contoh. Ha? Dua perkara berlaku serentak. Dua actions, ah, ha? Dua action. Iman Daniel, Kisha, Arjuna, Raif Ashad, Adam, Sofia,
yeah.
Actions, ah, ha? Fia, ingat eh, action, Fia. Two actions, ah, ha? He was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, She was setting the table. Meanwhile, she was setting the table. Okay, sila salin. Siapa yang dah siap, bolehlah angkat tangan.
Yeah.
Dah? Boleh sebagi page yang berikutnya?
Belum, belum, belum.
Yes.
Belum.
Sudah?
Dah.
Okey, berikutnya yang last sekali untuk untuk perkataan ini adalah nevertheless. Indicate a contrast between two ideas but with a caveat. Okey, dia punya susah sikit. Okey. Indicates a contrast between two ideas but with a caveat. Caveat ni adalah amaran. Amaran. Warning. Okay. Contohnya. He can be stubborn. Stubborn. Bukan stubborn. Stubborn. He can be stubborn. Oh, amaran. Itu adalah amaran. He can be stubborn kan? Dia ni boleh jadi degil lah. Amaran lah, amaran. Nevertheless, he is a loyal friend. Bila tak nevertheless, terus dia jadi kontras. He is a loyal friend. Kita bagi amaran dulu. Betul kita letak nevertheless untuk connect idea ini kepada ini. Okay. He is a loyal friend. So ingat eh, bila guna nevertheless ni mostly ayat pertama ini adalah amaran. Eh? Amaran. Okay, sila salin. Siapa dah siap salin boleh angkat tangan.
Sudah.
Thank you so much.
Dah.
Sudah, boleh saya pergi next?
Boleh.
Tapi
Belum.
Next lagi, senak kamu baca dulu supaya kamu dapat ingat seorang-seorang. Sebab kalau kamu tak baca, kejap lagi kamu jawab, kamu akan rasa macam Eh, susah ni nak jawab sebab kamu tak rasa lagi bacaan dia tu. So, kita letakkan tangan kamu semua balik. Kita mulakan dengan Iman Daniel. Cepat ya baca. One, two, three, go.
However, indicates a contrast between two ideas. Example, she loved to dance. However, she hates performing in front of large crowds. Therefore, indicates a result or conclusion. Example, he studied hard for the exam. Therefore, he got an A. Moreover, indicates an addition to the previous idea. Example, she is a talented musician. Moreover, she is an accomplished athlete. Meanwhile, indicates that two actions are happening simultaneously. Example, he was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, she was setting the table. Nevertheless, indicates a contrast between two ideas but with a caveat. Example, he can be stubborn. Nevertheless, he is a loyal friend.
Thank you, Akhil. Teruskan.
Over. Indicates a contrast between two ideas. Example, she loves to dance. However, she hates performing in front of large crowds. Therefore, indicates a result or conclusion. Example, he studied hard for the exam. Therefore, he got an A. Moreover, indicates an addition to the previous idea. Example, she is a talented musician. Moreover, she is an accomplished athlete. Meanwhile, indicates that the actions are happening simultaneously. Example, he was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, she was setting the table. Nevertheless, indicates a contrast between two ideas, but with a caveat. Example, he can be stubborn. Nevertheless, he is a loyal friend.
Thank you. Kisha.
Yes, sir.
Tufan.
However, indicates a contrast between two ideas. Example, she loves to dance. However, she hates performing in front of large crowds. Therefore, indicates a result or consolation. Example, he studied hard for the exam. Therefore, he got an A. Moreover, indicates an addition to the previous idea. Example, she is talented musician. Moreover, she is accomplished athlete. Meanwhile, indicates that two actions are happening simultaneously. Example, he was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, he was sitting the table. Nevertheless, indicates a contrast between two ideas but with a caveat. Example, he can be stubborn. Nevertheless, he is a loyal friend.
Thank you. Chris?
However, indicates a contrast between two ideas. Example, she loves to dance. However, she hates performing in front of large crowds. Therefore, indicates a result or conclusion. Example, he studied hard for the exam. Therefore, he got an A. Moreover, indicates an addition to the previous idea. Example, She is a talented musician. Moreover, she is an accomplished athlete. Meanwhile, indicates that two actions are happening simultaneously. He was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, she was setting the table. Nevertheless, indicates a contrast between two ideas, but with a caveat. He can be stubborn. Nevertheless, he is a loyal friend.
Thank you, Chris. Sophia. Sophia?
Yes, sir.
Ruskan?
However, indicates a contrast between two ideas. Example, she loved to dance. However, she had performed it in front of large crowd. Therefore, indicates a result or conclusion. Example, he studied hard for the exam. Therefore, he got an A. Moreover, indicates an addition to the previous idea. Example, she is a talented musician. Moreover, she is an accomplished athlete. Meanwhile, indicates that two actions are happening simultaneously. Example, he was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, she was setting the table. Nevertheless, indicates a contrast between two ideas, but with the caveat. Example, he can be stubborn. Nevertheless, he is a loyal friend.
Thank you so much. Very good, Sophia. Naura?
However, indicates a contrast between two ideas. Example, she loves to dance. However, she hates performing in front of large crowds. Therefore, indicates a result of conclusion. Example, he studied hard for the exam. Therefore, he got an A. Moreover, indicates an addition to the previous idea. Example, she is a talented musician. Moreover, she is an accomplished athlete. Meanwhile, indicates that two actions are happening simultaneously. Example, he was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, she was setting the table. Nevertheless, indicates a contrast between two ideas, but with a caveat. Example, he can be stubborn. Nevertheless, he is a loyal friend.
Thank you, Nara. Very good. Arjuna, ready?
Okay.
That's fine.
However, indicates a contrast between two ideas. Example, she loves to dance. However, she hates performing in front of large crowds. Therefore, indicates a result or conclusion. Example, he studied hard for the exam. Therefore, he got an A. Moreover, indicates an education to the previous idea. Example, she is talented musician. Moreover, she is an accomplished athlete. Meanwhile, indicates that two actions are happening simultaneously. Example, he was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, she was sitting the table. Nevertheless, indicates a contrast between two ideas, but with a caveat. Example, he can be stubborn. Nevertheless, he is a loyal friend.
Very good. Tanya kepada Ahmadi Arjuna, murid tahun 4 Al-Farabi di atas kejayaan memenangi tempat ketiga dalam pertandingan reka cipta Fun Game Wonderful Sea Creatures peringkat kebangsaan dengan menggunakan perisian Scratch 3.0. Beliau menerima sijil penyertaan dan pencapaian serta turut memenangi hadiah berupa kelas coding online. Betul Kak Yuna?
Betul.
Congratulations. Okay. Raif, ready? Raif Arshad, ready?
In this, a contest between Chinese observers, she loves to dance her worship performing in front of large crowds. Therefore, indicates a result or conclusion. Example, he studied hard for the exam, therefore he got an A. Moreover, indicates in addition to the previous idea. Example, she is a talented musician. Moreover, she is an accomplished athlete. Meanwhile, it indicates that two actions are happening simultaneously. Example, he was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, she was setting the table. Nevertheless, indicates a contrast between two ideas but we should give it. Example, he can be stubborn. Nevertheless, he is a loyal friend.
Thank you so much, Adam.
However, indicates a contrast between two ideas. Example, she loves students. However, she is performing in front of large crowds.
Jocelyn.
Therefore, indicates a result or condition. Example, he studied hard for the exam. Therefore, he got an A. Moreover, indicates an addition to the previous idea. Example, she is a talented musician. Moreover, she is an accomplished athlete. Meanwhile, indicates that two actions are happening simultaneously. Example, he was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, she was setting the table. Nevertheless, indicates a contrast between two ideas but with a caveat. Example, he can be stubborn. Nevertheless, he is a loyal friend.
Thank you so much, Adam. Muhammad Daniel.
Indicates between two ideas. Example, she loves to dance. However, she hates performing in front of large crowds. Therefore, indicates a result or conclusion. Example, he thinks to die hard for the exam, study hard for the exam. Therefore, he got an A. Moreover, indicates an addition to the previous idea. Example, she is a talented musician. Moreover, she is an accomplished athlete. Meanwhile, indicates that two actions are happening simultaneously. Example, he was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, she was sitting the
Therefore, he got an A. Okay, sorry. Nevertheless, kan? Okay, teruskan.
Nevertheless, indicates a contrast between two ideas, but with a case. Example, he can be stubborn. Nevertheless, He is a loyal friend.
Thank you so much, Pia. Pia.
Yes, sir.
Listen.
Didn't call me. Indicates a contrast between two ideas. Example, she loves to dance. However, she hates performing in front of leisure crowds.
Teruskan.
Indicates a result of or conclusion. Example, she studied hard for the exam, therefore he got an A. She is a indicates an addition to the previous idea. Example, she is a talented musician, moreover, he is an accomplished athlete. Indicates that two actions are happening simultaneously. Example, he was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, she was setting the table. Indicates a contrast between two ideas but with a habit. Example, he can be stubborn. Never tell, he is a loyal friend.
Thank you so much. Very good. Tarani. Tarani, you are next. Yes, Tarani. Masalah speaker kat tu. Something wrong again. Oh. I think you should change to the mobile phone lah, Tarani. If your laptop is having a problem, you can change to another gadget. Okay? Okay, tak apa, Tarani. It's okay. Nanti bahagian soalan bosan tanya Tarani balik, ha? Okay. Iman Dini ready. Practice A. Terus jawab. Baca and jawab.
It was beautiful day at the beach. The strong wave makes me. However,
Moreover. Bukankah itu ayat bertentangan? It was a beautiful day at the beach. The strong waves made swimming difficult. Ayat kontra. Contrast. Apa jawapannya?
Moreover.
Moreover bukan contrast. Moreover adalah addition. Penambahan. Therefore, sebab dan akibat. Meanwhile, sementara. Nevertheless adalah macam macam tu juga tapi dengan caveat. Caveat tu adalah amaran. So, apa jawapan Aiman Daniel? Aiman Daniel? Apa jawapan Aiman Daniel?
Nevertheless.
Nevertheless, mesti ada caveat. Caveat tu amaran. Ada tak amaran dalam ayat ni? Dia beritahu, it was a beautiful day. Beautiful tu, day tu ada amaran ke?
Okay.
So, apa jawapan yang tinggal?
Meanwhile
tu sementara. Ya Allah, Iman Danielku. Baru salin nota, baru baca. Sebab tu saya suruh salin. Nampak tak kawan-kawan? Kena salin. Ya, yeah. Tak salin ke apa tu?
Oh. Therefore.
Therefore tu sebab dan akibat. Ini bukan sebab dan akibat. Kalau sebab dan akibat, it was beautiful day. Sebab beautiful day tu mereka tidak boleh berenang. Macam tu. Itu ke sebab dan akibat. Iman Daniel. Iman Daniel.
Ya.
Apa jawapan? Iman Daniel, tengok jawapan orang bagi kat chat tu Iman Daniel. Apa cadangan jawapan Kisha tu?
However.
Yes, however. Itu jawapan dia. Okay, cuba baca. Sekali lagi.
It was a beautiful day at the beach. However, the strong wave match remained difficult.
Yes, thank you, Iman Daniel.
Saya dah cakap dah, however tadi.
Tak dengar. Okay, good. Thank you. Okay, Tarani, baca.
However, indicates a contrast between two ideas. Example, she loves to dance. However, she hates performing in front of large crowds. Therefore, indicates a result or conclusion. In example, he studied hard for the exam. Therefore, he got an A.
Yang lain tolong dengar dan ingat balik ah ha? Fungsi-fungsi dia tu.
Moreover, indicates an addition to the previous idea. Example, she is talented musician. Moreover, she is an accomplished athlete. Meanwhile, indicates that two actions are happening simultaneously. Example, she was cooking dinner. Meanwhile, she was setting the table. Nevertheless, indicates a contrast between two ideas, but with a caveat. Example, he can be stubborn. Nevertheless, he is a loyal friend.
Very good. Thank you so much. Okay, berikutnya. Akira yang sila jawab. Baca jawab.
Jawapan.
Baca semua dan jawab.
I studied hard for the exam. Therefore, I feel confident going in.
Betul. Mantap. Congratulations. Kisha, your turn.
Yes, sir. Exercise is good for your physical health.
Exercise. Bagus untuk fizikal. Pertama. Exercise. Bagus untuk boost mood. So, dia mengenai exercise. Fakta-fakta mengenai exercise. Fakta pertama, good for physical health. Fakta kedua, boost your mood. So, apakah jawapan Kisha? Dia lah tambahan saja.
Nevertheless.
No. Dia ada tambahan.
Oh, moreover.
Yes, moreover. Baca sekali lagi.
Exercise is good for your physical health. Moreover, it can also boost your mood.
Very good. Thank you. Chris, cuba jawab.
The firefighters battle the blaze. The police evacuate nearby homes. The firefighters battle the blaze. Meanwhile, the police evacuate nearby homes.
Thank you so much. Very good. Okay. More meanwhile. Okay. Berikutnya adalah Sofia. Sofia? Sofia.
Yes, sir.
Teruskan. Saya dan jawab.
The project first mentioned and the team persevered and finished on time.
The project faced many challenges. Ada warning dekat situ.
Yep, sir.
Banyak warning dekat situ. The project faced many challenges. Dia ada caveat dekat situ. So yang mana satu jawapan dia?
Meanwhile,
ada caveat. Tengok nota balik. Yang mana ada tulisan caveat. Tengok nota balik. Mesti tengok nota. Macam mana mesti tengok nota?
Nevertheless, the project faced many challenges. Nevertheless, the team persevered and finished on time.
Okay, jawapannya never, apa dia?
Nevertheless.
Yes, very good. Congratulations, Sofia. Ingatkan nota sangat penting, Sofia. Nota itulah yang akan bantu Sofia dalam exam, dalam kehidupan, dalam mana-mana je lah. Sebab nota tu rujuk balik. Apa-apa nota yang saya ajar kamu pada dulu, Sofia, sampai sekarang, rujuk balik. Especially Iman Daniel ni. Nota yang bertimbun-timbun sebagi dulu kan, Iman Daniel, ha? Pak daripada Pak Up punya. Rujuk balik. Semua tu penting tu. Okay, thank you, Sofia. Good try. Okay, Naura. Please read the questions and answer. Naura?
I love spending time with friends. I also need some quiet to alone to recharge.
Sebagai clue, dia contrast.
However,
yes, very good. Baca sekali lagi dengan however.
I love spending time with friends. However, I also need some quiet time alone to recharge.
Very good. Thank you, Nora. Arjuna, silakan.
The battery life on this phone is terrible. Yeah. Meanwhile, I need to keep a charger with me at all times.
This is, Arjuna, the cause and the second sentence is all about.
Nevertheless.
No. The cause. The second sentence is about the effect.
However.
However tu kontra. Ini course and no, baca nota balik. Kan saya kata jangan screenshot. Baca nota balik.
Ni. The battery life on this phone is terrible. Therefore, I need to keep a charger with me at all times.
Very good. Good job, Arjuna. Pandai pun Arjuna. Alhamdulillah. Okay. Good try, ya. Eh? Very good, very good, very good. Okay, now, Adam. Baca dan jawab.
Reading is a great way to learn new things.
Baca dan jawab.
Moreover, it can also improve your focus and concentration.
Very good. So, macam mana nak kena pasti ayat itu, Adam? Kenapa pilih moreover, Adam? Okay, it's a big clue. Dia talk about reading. Ini adalah ayat pertama. Ini adalah ayat kedua. So, reading. Perasan atau tidak, dia menggunakan it dekat sini yang mana merujuk kepada reading. So, di situ kita dapat agak reading is a great way to learn. Okay, is a great way to learn new things. Okay. Dan dia tambah lagi, reading juga improve your focus and concentration. Adam, ada dua maklumat yang diberi. So, itu membawa masuk apa ni, Adam? Maklumat kedua tu adalah maklumat tambah?
Hai.
Tambahan. So, bila ada maklumat tambahan, Adam, kita kena guna?
Moreover.
Moreover. Very good, Adam. Thank you so much. Okay, Muhammad Daniel, sila baca dan jawab.
The cake was baking in the oven. I whipped up some frosting.
Very good.
Meanwhile?
Yes. Very good. Ada pizza apa ni? Oh, sorry guys. Meanwhile. Okay, betul. Kau lagi baca?
The cake was baking in the oven. Meanwhile, I whipped up some frosting.
Very good. So guys, the cake was baking in the oven. So how about kita buat dia baking in the oven adalah 7:30 PM. I whip up some frosting pun waktu 7:30 PM. So benda ni berlaku serentak, simultaneously. So bila sesuatu perkara berlaku serentak, okay, Muhammad Daniel kena menggunakan mean?
Why?
Meanwhile. Itu penerangan dia. Nampak tak? Baru jelas kan? Bila contoh kan? Okay, thank you Muhammad Daniel. You have a correct answer. Okay, Fia, baca dan jawab. Fia, are you there? Pia?
Yes, sir.
Teruskan. Baca dan jawab.
The instruction seems complete.
The instructions seemed complicated.
I decided to give it a try and managed to bolt the bookshelf successfully.
So, apa jawapan dia?
The instructions seems complicated, however.
Complicated, complicated mana datang tu? Apa jawapan Pia? So, bagi clue lagi. Instructions seem complicated. This is a warning. So, apakah jawapan Pia? Benda yang ada warning ni nak guna yang mana? Pia?
Nevertheless.
You never the last. Okay, sila baca yang lengkap.
The instruction seems completed. Completed. Nevertheless, I devised to give it a try and managed to build the bookshelf successfully.
Very good. Thank you. Yeah. Tarani.
The movie had a great plot. The acting was a bit disappointing.
Job.
The acting was a bit disappointing. The movie had a great plot. Therefore, the acting was a bit disappointing.
Karani, movie had a great plot. Acting disappointing. Contrast, Karani. Ini dengan ini adalah contrast. Apa jawapan Karani kalau untuk contrast? Cari nota. Yang mana? However. Baca sekali lagi.
The movie had a great plot. However, the acting was a bit disappointing.
Thank you so much. Iman Daniel.
Yes.
Baca dan jawab. Minute.
Early. To avoid traffic, let's aim to be out the door by 7 p.m.
Apa jawapan?
Ya.
We need to leave early to avoid traffic. This is the cause, sebab. Let's aim out the door by 7 p.m. Ini adalah the effect. So, apa jawapan?
Come over. However.
Ni jawapannya. Cuba baca. Ayat lengkap.
We need to leave early to avoid traffic. Therefore, let's aim to be out the door by 7 p.m.
Okay. Therefore. Okay. So, punca dia nak elak traffic. Kesan dia keluar pukul tu 7. Okay. Iman Daniel lah. Okay. Akhil, teruskan.
He's a talented artist. She's also a gifted musician.
Ayat pertama, Akhil, dia adalah fakta pertama. Kemudian dia tambah lagi fakta kedua mengenai perempuan ini. Apa jawapan dia? She's a talented artist.
She's a talented artist. However,
dia adalah ayat tambahan ini fakta yang kedua. Nampak tak? She ini berhubung dengan she ini.
Moreover.
Moreover. Very good. Okay, very good. Moreover. Thank you so much. Berikutnya, Muhammad Daniel.
The kids were playing outside. The adults were having a conversation inside.
The kids were playing outside. The adults were having a conversation inside. Action ini adalah action pertama berlaku secara serentak dengan action yang kedua. So, apakah jawapan Muhammad Daniel? Simultaneously. Apa dia? Muhammad Daniel? Moreover bukan. Moreover tambahan. Ini adalah berlaku secara simultaneously. Tengok nota simultaneously. Okay, so tolong M-O-R-E. Tambah lagi, apa lagi?
Over.
Yeah, moreover. Baca sekali nafas.
The kids were playing outside. Moreover, the adults were having a conversation inside.
Okay, minta maaf. Meanwhile, sorry. Saya pun pening lah. Nganyok lah ni. Okay, baca sekali lagi.
The kids were playing outside. Meanwhile, the adults were having a conversation inside.
Very good. Thank you so much, Muhammad Daniel. Okay, Kisha, teruskan. Baca dan jawab.
Yes, sir. He was feeling nervous about the presentation. He managed to deliver it confidently. Get that, sir?
Mm-hmm.
He was feeling nervous about the presentation. However, he managed to deliver it confidently.
Hampir tepat, tetapi this one is about feeling nervous about the presentation. However, boleh guna, tapi lebih tepat ada satu lagi.
Nevertheless.
Yes, never.
Less.
Thank you so much. Very good, Kisha. Chris, cuba jawab. Baca dan jawab. Chris, satu. Chris, dua. Chris, tiga. Norris point. Sophia.
Yes, sir.
Okay, teruskan.
I took go for a walk. It starts pouring rain as soon as I step outside. Meanwhile?
I wanted to go for a walk. I wanted to go for a walk. It started pouring rain as soon as I stepped outside. Sorry. Dia long sikit lah ni.
Sebelah.
Apa jawapan dia? Moreover, sure. We yes. need to buy grocery. I wanted to go for a walk. It started pouring rain as soon as I stepped outside. Kamu kata moreover.
Nevertheless, it started pouring rain.
I wanted to go for a walk. Dia susah sikit. Tak apa, kita fikir sama-sama. Saya tunggu jawapan kamu juga, jangan risau. I wanted to go for a walk. Ini adalah pertama. Yang pertama. It started pouring rain as soon as I stepped outside. This is yang kedua. Okay, sebagai clue. Dia adalah contrast. Dia adalah contrast, Sofia.
Nevertheless.
Nevertheless tu contrast tapi ada amaran. Ini tak ada amaran.
However.
Yes, however. Baca sekali lagi.
I wanted to go for a walk, however, it started to rain as soon as I stepped outside.
Thank you so much. Okay, Nara, baca dan jawab.
We need to buy groceries. Let's make a list before heading to the store.
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile.
Meanwhile itu perkara yang berlaku serentak. We need to buy groceries. Ini adalah sebab dia.
Therefore.
Therefore. Baca sekali lagi.
We need to buy groceries. Therefore, let's make a list before heading to the store.
Thank you so much, Nara. Very good. Arjuna.
Yep. Traveling is a great way to express new cultures. However, it can broaden your perspective on the world.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Nampak tak penggunaan it dekat sini? Dia merujuk dekat travelling. Okay, faham?
Faham.
Travelling is a great way to experience new culture. Fakta pertama. It merujuk pada travelling. It can broaden your perspective of world.
Meanwhile?
No. Ini adalah fakta yang kedua.
Yep. Tengok buku. Kesana.
Dia nak tambahan fakta. Traveling fakta pertama, a great way to experience new culture. Dia tambah lagi fakta, broaden your perspective of the world. Apa jawapan dia?
Marvelous? Jap.
Adalah menambahkan fakta. Addition.
However, bukan.
Saya nak tolong.
Boleh.
Moreover.
Moreover. Thank you. Okay, Arjuna, sila baca.
Traveling is a great way to explore new cultures. However, it can broaden your perspective on the world.
Very good. Thank you, Arjuna. Good job. Adam. Adam.
The computer was running over the scan. Meanwhile, I decided to organize my desk.
Very good. Okay. Okay, baca sekali lagi.
The computer was running a virus scan. Meanwhile, I decided to organize my desk.
Very good. Thank you so much. Fia? Fia. Laju, Fia.
Public speaking can be anything.
Yes, could be intimidating. Warning.
Ridiculous.
Yes.
Public speaking. Intimidating, nevertheless, with practice, you can become more comfortable with it.
Never, sorry. Tak terasa sehodoh kejap, sorry. Ya Allah, ya Tuhanku. Never done that. Okay, baca sekali lagi. Pia?
Public speaking could be intimidating, nevertheless, with practice, you can become more comfortable with it.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Okay, thank you, Fia. Tarani, turn on your mic. Kita akan masuk bahagian reading terus. Okay, Tarani, turn on your mic. No response. Kita minta Iman Daniel mula dulu. Okay, terus ke Iman Daniel.
It was a beautiful day at the beach. However, the strong wave made swimming difficult.
Okay, good job. Akhir Ryan. Seorang satu lah. Saya tak lepas semua seorang semua. Nanti kot 10 dah. Akhir Ryan, terus ke macam.
I studied hard for the exam. Therefore, I felt confident going in.
Very good. Thank you, Muhammad Daniel.
Exercise is good for your spatial health. Moreover, it can also boost your mood.
Very nice. Good job. Keisha.
The firefighters battled the blast while the police evacuated nearby home.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Thank you. Chris.
The project faced many challenges. Nevertheless, the team persevered and finished on time.
Nevertheless. Baca sekali lagi.
The project faced many challenges. Nevertheless, the team persevered and finished on time.
Okay, saya nak betulkan untuk sebutan ni, Chris. Persevered.
Persevered.
Yes. Dia asalnya persevered ni maksudnya bertahan. Okay, very good. Thank you so much, Chris, for the reading. Very good job. Okay, Sofia. So, akan dengar betul-betul bacaan kamu. So, akan tengok yang mana diperlukan betul, kan? Okay, Sofia, baca.
I love spending time with friends. However, I also need some quiet time alone to recharge.
Okay, no problem. Very good. Nora?
The battery life on this phone is terrible. Therefore, I need to keep a charge with me at all times.
Okay. Terrible. Cuba sebut. Terrible.
Terrible.
Very good. Thank you. Arjuna.
Reading is a great way to learn new things. Moreover, it can also improve your focus and concentration.
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 Very good. Thank you. Adam.
The cake was baking in the oven. Meanwhile, I whipped up some frosting.
Very good, very good. Wait. Okay, next. Pia. Pia, laju.
The instruction seems complicated. Nevertheless, I decide to give it a try and manage to build the bookshelf successfully.
Very good. Fia, ini sebutannya instructions.
Instructions.
Very good. Thank you. Tarani. Tarani. Okay, Raif Arshad.
The movie had a good plot. However, the acting was a bit disappointing.
Ini?
Need to leave early to avoid traffic. Therefore, it's aimed to be out the door by 7 p.m.
Okay. Very good. Good job. Thank you. Tarani? Okay, no response from Tarani lah. Okay, nice. So, saya tak boleh sentuh semua sebab nanti dah 10-9 minit dah. Okay, thank you so much. Very good. So, inilah conjunctive adverb 5 ini sangat senang digunakan. However, therefore, moreover, meanwhile dan juga nevertheless. So saya nak kamu salin nota supaya ingatan kamu double, triple, dapat ingat lama-lama yang apa kamu belajar hari ini. Congratulations. So thank you semua. Thank you Imadina. Thank you Daniel. Thank you Aki Ryan, Tisha, Chris, Sofia, Arjuna, Tarani, Rev Asha and Fia. Good night everyone. Kita jumpa lagi pada minggu hadapan sesi terbaru Mei. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good night everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Good night, sir.
Thank you. Bye.